गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। टुडे वी आर लर्निंग फॉर न्यू सेशन लार्जर नंबर इन प्रैक्टिस। बट टुडे वी आर लर्निंग लार्जर नंबर इन प्रैक्टिस। बिफोर टुडे इन प्रीवियस सेशन वी आर लर्निंग हाउ टू राइट डाउन द नेम नंबर इन नेम फॉर्म एंड नेम टू नंबर फॉर्म इन लार्जर नंबर इन इंडियन सिस्टम ऑफ न्यूमरेशन एंड इंटरनेशनल सिस्टम ऑफ न्यूमरेशन। In million, billion is international system of numeration and lakh, crore is in Indian system of numeration. Today we are learning unit of length. So all of you know on your scale. On your scale we know that on our small scale of 1 to 15 number is given. Is known as centimeter. When we measure the length of pencil or our book, we use centimeter. So 1 to 15 centimeter there. Then how many points are there in 1 centimeter? 10. Therefore we know that 1 centimeter equal to 10 millimeter. And if we find out the longer distance, suppose length of classroom or length of school, then we use meter. Therefore 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. Here if we write down the meter in millimeter, then what we are doing? 100 centimeter into 10 millimeter. Means 1000 millimeter. Same way, one more measure length of kilometer. Kilometer means how many meter? We are known that kilometer is 1000 meter. Or if we write down the kilometer in centimeter, then 1000 into 100 centimeter. If we write down in millimeter, 1000 into 1000 millimeter. Okay, all of you understand how to convert the kilometer into meter, meter into centimeter, and centimeter into millimeter. Understand? Then next topic, weight. Weight, unit of weight. So we are known what is the unit of weight. All we are known unit of weight is kilogram, gram and milligram. So we know kilogram, gram and milligram. But what is the relation between them? So 1 kilogram. 1 kilogram means how many gram? 1000 gram. 1000 gram. We write down smaller record unit GM and smaller unit of kilometer kilogram is kg. Okay? And 1 gram. 1 gram means how many milligram? 1000 milligram. 1000 milligram. How many milligram? 1 gram is equal to 1000 milligram and 1 milligram means 1 kilogram means 1000 gram. Where we use kilogram is used in mostly where we use larger quantity of grocery. Gram we use smaller quantity and milligram we use medicine. Then the medicine is mostly weighed in milligram because it is very smaller quantity. Otherwise we purchase gold or silver, then it is also in milligram. Okay. Then next we use capacity. Capacity means the measurement of liquid. How we measure the liquid? So we use measure liquid in liter. Which liter? Liter means how many milliliter? In 1 liter, 1000 milliliter is there. How many milliliter? 1000 milliliter. In daily life, we are known that if we purchase pouch of milk, means how many milliliters? 500 milliliters. We know that the logo is there, 500 ml. If we purchase two pouch, then what happens? 1000 ml is known as 1 liter. Understand all of you? Centimeter to millimeter, meter to centimeter, and kilometer to meter. Means larger unit is kilometer of length. Then meter, then centimeter, then millimeter. Same way in weight, kilogram. 1 kilogram means 1000 gram, or 1 gram means 1000 milligram. Same way capacity of liquid means liquid measure karna hai. The 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter, and if we combine 500 ml 2 times, then we get 1 liter. Okay. Now we are learning kilometer, meter, gram, kilometer, meter, centimeter, and millimeter. Then kilogram, gram, and milligram. Then liter and milliliter. Now let us learn one example. If one bus is starting from A to B, B to C, and C to D, the bus speed is given here 60 km/h, and the distance is given here from A to B, B to C, C to D, B to T. Here we want to find out the distance between A to, when the bus is coming again B, A. Then what we are doing? We add all the kilometers and find out the length. But if we find out the distance between A to C, what we are doing? So, find out distance between A to C. What we are doing? We are doing first add A to B and B to C. Therefore, distance of A to B is 4170 km. And distance of B to C equal to 3410 km. We add both, then what happened? 0, 7 plus 1, 8, 4 plus 1, 5, 4 plus 3, 7. We know that the total distance of A to C is 7580 km. Remember what when we calculate the example with unit. When we given answer, we put the unit after the calculation. Clear? Okay. The A to B. Same way you are find out the measurement from A to E. If you find out the total distance from A to E, A to B, B to C, C to D, and A to E. Same way, if you find out difference between A to B or B to C, what is the difference between A to B and B to C? So what we are doing? We are write down first. Find out difference A to B and B to C. So now what we are doing? We find out the width length is larger here, A to B length is larger, and B to C length is smaller. So we subtract from B to C from A to B. The length of A to B is equal to 4170 km. Then B to C is 3410 km. Understand what we are doing here? Here we are doing subtraction. Means we are all larger number, we are add, subtract, multiply, and divide. 0, 7 minus 1, 6. Here 1 minus 4 is not given. So we carry here, we write down 3 here, and write down here 11.
11 minus 4, 7 and 0. Then the difference, the distance A to B is 760 km more than B to C. Understand, boys? Okay. Then one more example we want to learn, how to find out to reach from A to B. If the bus is started from A and the speed of bus is 60 km/h, so what is the time to reach from A to B? Here we find out time to reach from A to B. Here the in example the speed is given 60 km/h, means in 60 km we want to cover 60 km, then how much time we want? 1 hour. How much time we want? 1 hour. But how many distance is there? 4170 km, equal to how many? So we write down here 4170 divided 60. We are known, we start from here 2 digits, so we start from here 2 digits. But this 2 digits is smaller than 60, so we get 3 digits. Then we make table 60 into 6, then 360. 60 into 7 means 420. The 420 is larger than this number, we do not use, so we use 60 sixes are 360. 7, again we cut this and carry over 11 minus 6, 5. Then we put down 0 here, then 69, 540. 7 minus 4, 3, 0. Now 30 is remainder. Now what we are doing? We put 0 here after point. Then we get this 0 is downstairs and write down 300. Then 65 is 300. Then we get 0. Here we put here point, so also we are put here point. Then how much time? The time taken 69.5 hours to reach A to B. If we write down 0.5 in minutes, what we are doing? We again change the units of hours in minute. We all are known 1 hour means 60 minutes. So we write down here 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. Then 0.5 hours is equal to 0.5 into 60 means 30.0 minutes. So we write down here 69 hours and 30 minutes. Understand all of you? If any measurement is given, we find out with addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. We are learning today addition, subtraction and division. In multiplication, we in our daily life we purchase 1 pen or 10 pen. We put multiplication. Okay, students. Now we are learning our next session, our example. Okay, all of you observe this video properly and understand the relation between our units. Okay, now stay safe, stay at home. Have a nice day.